Hello everyone, I'm Hesterry, and this is episode 7 of my shipbuilding tutorial. So I've been doing a fair bit of thinking in the interim. I know it's been a while since I've made one of these. But I have some thoughts about this thing. Some good, some bad. But I'm going to jump into it and sort of talk as I work, or try to anyway. So the first thing I'm going to do... Oh, the first thing I should mention, actually, is that I'm now using the, what's it called, the Build Info mod by Digi. And I think this mod's pretty essential for building in creative, even in survival, if you can wing it. Because it tells you a lot of useful information about the different blocks you're placing. So, if I remember to, I will include a link to that in the description of the video. Anyway... What I'm going to do right now is trim down this space I've allocated for timers and programmable blocks. Actually, I'm going to place them, might as well. And I'm going to add in some gravity shielding. Because I kept forgetting to add that before. So, we're going to do it now. What's the best way to do this? I need more timers than programs. Right? Yeah. So what I can do... I don't know why I'm taking so long to do this. What I can do... is fill that in. And then... add a whole lot of timers. And some programmable blocks there. That is more than enough to do pretty much everything I need to. Partly because of the thinking I've been doing, which again, I'll get to in a moment. Gravity. Oops. Yeah. Gravity shielding. Let's do... all of this. And let's turn these off. Because that noise is awful. Alright, there we go. That's plenty. That is actually maybe too much. 3, 7. What is that? 21, 42 G's of shielding? That's fine. It's not too much, not too little. Alright. So, my thinking was that this project has taken way too long. Not just... in terms of, like, recording efforts, but some of the work I've had to do outside of it, and editing, and basically I'm done with it. I am so done with this project. And it's not just because of the time, it's also because I've learned a lot in the time I've spent working on it. What else was I going to do? I was going to remodel some of the armor and add in turrets. So I'm doing that. So yeah, I've basically spent too long time-wise, too much time over the past few months working on this thing, and in that time, I've learned a fair bit about shipbuilding and the like. And basically, this thing is just outdated. It's old. I took too long to make it, basically. And that's entirely on me. So yeah, turrets there. My god, it is hard to work and think at the same time. Let's do this. That's good. Alright. So, while I could dump in, you know, a few more hours of effort to bring this thing up to snuff and actually finish it, I say a few hours, it's probably going to take more like 20 hours off camera. Well, that might be exaggerating. Maybe 10 to 15 hours off camera, just setting this thing up, setting up the programmable blocks, figuring out how I'm going to organize or set up all of these torpedoes to launch with the gravity. Basically, it's too much work for an outdated project. So here's what I'm going to do. I am going to finish the ship externally. I will put all the components in, I'll fill in the armor, I'll detail it, I'll paint it, I'll do all of that. But I am not going to set up these programmable blocks and timers, I'm not going to configure the action bars, all that stuff. So the ship will be finished, but it will not be fully functional, I guess. It will not be usable, per se. You could fly it if you wanted, but yeah, I'm not going to invest the extra time to actually make it a workshop-ready ship, a combat-ready ship, whatever you want to call it. Simply because, again, it's too much work, it's too old. What else was I going to do? Oh, I was going to, and this is part of the problem that I'm about to get to, I was going to replace some of this armor with light armor, because I've come to the conclusion, and people were telling me this on the forums and I didn't listen at the time, I've come to the conclusion that there's a lot of space in here that doesn't need to be heavy armor. There's just no reason for it. Ooh, I'm actually going to need those thrusters. Maybe. Let's grab those again. So yeah. What armor did I want to replace, first of all? Oh, I also need to trim the armor back a bit. There's no reason for it to be as heavy as it is. Oh, I also need to add more gyros. Let's do the gyros right now. Oh, that's actually going to be a problem. All facing this way. Alright, that's enough, Mary. Let's do this. So yeah, that's the gist of it, basically. Again, I'll do what I can to make it look good, I guess. And maybe in the future I'll change my mind and actually come back and finish this thing. But I think more than likely, it's basically already ready to be remade because it's outdated. Partly due to game changes, mostly due to my experience and skill as a shipbuilder changing. How can I get these in here? Come on. Yeah. I'll just have to do that. All right. What else? Oh, I need to do the other side too, and some back here. There we go. I have to do the bottom. Nice thing about gyros is that they actually double as armor. They're quite strong. And this is why the build info mod is actually quite useful. Well, I should have been building with it from the beginning. As you can see, the integrity of a gyro is 63,000. That's basically its health before it breaks. A heavy block of armor is 16,500. Now, granted, I think gyros are heavier. 12, 4 times. Yeah, they're roughly equivalent in weight to health, but the gyro simply has more health. Oh, I forgot a line of gyros right here. So, that makes gyros quite an interesting tool as a potential armor replacement. Also, I may have mentioned this before and forgotten, but you should always put gyros on top of, like, connecting to essential parts of the ship. Because if a gyro gets detached and starts floating around inside of your ship, that's gonna be a nightmare. You don't want that to happen. So by attaching them to an essential part of the ship, your bigger concern, if they get detached, is that you lost something important, like your cockpit, or a reactor, or cargo. Let's see how that handles. I think I'll add some to the bottom as well. So that's just a good little philosophy to have. Is there anything else I wanted to talk about? I feel like there's more. I feel like there's always more that I want to talk about. I'm just forgetting. Oh, there isn't any room down here. I guess that's okay. So right here is actually a good example of one of the problems with this ship. And partly this came up due to poor planning, but experience really played a part here. This is all empty space. And I think I said I was going to fill it with gyros, but it's going to add too much weight. It's kind of arbitrary. If I had better planned this out, as I would probably be able to do now, I would not have all that empty space there. I don't know what I would fill it out with. I'd probably just like trim this down or something like that. Or shorten it here. Like not have all this extending out and instead put the stuff I have in that part of the ship in here. I think it's mostly tanks and cargo. Tanks and reactors, yeah. I would have moved them up here, but it's kind of too late. While I could, you know, rework all that, it would just take too long. So I'm going to try and finish this ship up over the next couple of episodes. I might even be able to finish it this episode. Probably not. I have to do a lot of work off camera, which I am going to do. Anyway, I would have to do so much work to make this thing functional again. Oh, crap. Let's try the mirror again. It just isn't worth it. So yeah, I'm going to finish it up, hopefully in the next episode or two, and then just be done with it. And I will upload this to the workshop when it's finished, as well as what I had for each episode. I've saved separate blueprints, basically, of where I was at the end of every episode, so I'll be able to upload those as well. And then just move on to other things. That's where I'm at. I want to move on. Alright. So what I'm going to do now is go through and replace some of this internal armor with light, because there's no reason for it to be heavy. Alright, see you guys in a minute. Alright, we're back. So I'm going to go over the changes I made off camera, and then there are a couple other things I want to talk about. So first of all, as you can see, I replaced a fair bit of heavy armor with light. And there's still more to do in this regard. I'm going to replace probably most of this, most of all this armor on the inside here and here and so on will all be light armor. And we'll leave, obviously, these outside plates and some of the armor around the thrusters will stay heavy. But the rest will be pretty much light. And then I did some of the interior as well. Yeah. These braces and so on. And as you can see, I replaced the antennas and I turned them so they're on their sides now. And this has a few effects. First of all, it uses less space in a way. You don't have this asymmetry of them like sticking up like this and leaving a gap that way. And it leaves this open, so if a player were in here, they can easily fly between the top and bottom halves of the ship. So for that reason, I'm also thinking I'm going to be leaving a lot of this open. Not completely hollow, but leaving it somewhat open as a form of access, because this is a combat ship. And it is going to take a beating, so having some open space so players can, you know, crawl in here and repair damage isn't exactly a bad thing. It's not ideal. It's better to have ships be as dense as possible, but it's not horrible. What else did I do? Oh, I filled out the control center a bit. Let's crawl in here. So as you can see, I now have LCDs, and behind these LCDs, there are remote control blocks. Let's toggle off that. Yeah, that's a remote control, and there's three on each side now. And, you know, I did a little bit of detailing here. I added an air vent. These are going to be doorways. Oh, I added two air vents. Huh. These are going to be doorways that will lead into these sort of access shafts around the ship. I also, I think that was it. Oh yeah, I just moved the conveyors to accommodate the air vents. And I think that is actually it. Looking at my list here. Oh, I fixed some mirroring issues, but that's not important. I don't even remember where those changes occurred. Huh. What else did I do? There's one other thing. Oh, decoys. Right. So I replaced those blocks with actual decoys. So I'm gonna do the turrets, and then I think that will be it for this episode. And I'm not gonna do it with a mirroring. And normally I don't mirror things because I wanna easily group and name them. And even though I'm not going to be going through and naming everything, because, as I said earlier, I'm not gonna completely polish this ship up. But it's still a good habit to have, to get used to doing certain things manually. And, you know, for the sake of demonstration. So doing it this way, it'd be really easy to just go in and, you know, grab the group of blocks that I want to name and say, like, oh, these are all the port side turrets, these are all the starboard side turrets, etc. And I'm doing them this way, with the missiles in the middle and the Gatlings up here, so it is less likely that, you know, if I had the missiles up here, there's a chance that aiming down they could shoot these other turrets. This will help mitigate that type of problem. Pretty straightforward. So the other thing I wanted to talk about is that even though this ship is outdated and I'm not going to be finishing it, I want to make it clear that the concepts and whatnot that I've gone over in this tutorial series are all relevant. They will never not be relevant, I think. The game would have to completely change for them to become irrelevant. So yeah, this is all pretty much just a learning experience. Oops, wrong turrets. Ha. So even though, you know, ooh, weird. Why did that? Is that a? Okay, I don't know what happened there. So yeah, even though this ship is outdated, I'm not gonna finish it. It's still a valuable learning experience for me, and hopefully for you guys as well. That, you know, some of my ideas were incorrect. But the concept of going through the five steps, we've only gone through four so far. The concept of, you know, coming up with an idea for your ship and then maybe doing a sketch of the layout, building the layout, fleshing it out, and so on, all of that is still good. And I still use it for my newer ships as well. So it's not like, even though this ship itself isn't good, it's not as though the tutorial has been a waste of time. Because it definitely hasn't. And I hope you guys don't feel it has. Alright, so that's it for the side turrets. Wall of guns! Kind of ridiculous, but whatever. Now, inside, I think I'm only gonna do Gatlings. Oops. Think I'm only gonna do Gatlings here. Because I don't want them to accidentally blow up these thrusters and. Oh, actually, that might cause burnout. That's a problem. Actually, it's not really a problem. I can put interiors there. The biggest threat here would be players trying to dig into the ship. So having some interior turrets here is actually not a bad thing. And it avoids potential burnout without having to rearrange the ship or anything. And then I can just put Gatlings here, and that's fine. Do, and I'll go do the same on the bottom. Perfect. Right. I'm OCD, I like them all oriented the same. Plus, if you're looking for like a panel to access, having everything oriented similarly is a good thing. Less flying around trying to figure out where things go. Oh, that's a mistake. I should have put these down first. Whatever, not gonna change it. Alright, let me make sure that is actually all I wanted to do today. Oh, did I put projectors on this thing? I did not. Wow. I did put the gravity shield down though, right? Yeah, I did that earlier. So we need some projectors. Now, this is actually a kind of important thing. If you're having something printable on your ship, like torpedoes, they're not going to be printable on this ship. But if you have anything like this, it's good to have a separate set of projectors for each torpedo or each set of torpedoes, so you don't have to project the whole ship to weld them on. This is very nice for performance and all around just a good idea. So I want to have more than one projector here. And of course, even though these are not printable, there won't be like a welder set in here to weld them on in combat or out of combat. It can still be a good idea to have separate projectors. So again, you don't have to project the whole ship, just to weld on a new set of weapons. So I'm thinking what I will do is I will have one projector for each of these hangars. And then two for the ship itself and different ends. So if one gets destroyed, there'll be a backup. So what I'll do... What is the best way to do this? I'm thinking, right here. Yeah, this will be fine. So I'll put a projector. Not sure how mirroring will behave, so I'm not gonna mirror these. I'll place them manually. Might not like flip them around correctly and whatnot, so we'll do it by hand. Alright, and then two for the ship. Where do I want these? Maybe I can squeeze them in somewhat near the cockpit. Isn't a whole lot of good space. Oh, I know where I can put them. I could actually put them in the cockpit. Maybe. Oh, that's another thing. I should have a projector on the cockpit so that if it gets damaged, it'll be easier to weld. Yeah, that'll work. And then maybe I don't need two of these. How did I turn this? No. There we go. All right. So I'll put one of these here, and then another one on this end. So, all that's left, you know, I'm not even going to do these torpedoes. Well, no, I'll paste some in. Or will I? All right, let's do the torpedoes. Actually, I'll do that off camera. Alright. Oh, shoot, I just noticed I made a mistake. let's fix that real quick. And we'll talk about what I just did. Okay, we're good. So these are pretty standard torpedoes. It's basically just two merge blocks, a battery, three mass blocks, and a bunch of blast door plates. Or blast doors, whatever they're called. Pretty basic. Wait a minute. I meant to shorten these. I made them bigger at first, and I realized they were too long for this space. easy fix. Alright, yeah, and this way I can put hangar doors here. Okay. So, pretty straightforward. Nothing special here. But they're effective. That's all that matters. Alright. So, that is pretty much it for this episode, and I just want to reiterate, before I call it a day, that even though I will not be completing this ship, making it workshop ready, as it were, everything I've gone over in this tutorial is still good information, and I hope you guys don't think that the process is bad. Because again, I still use this 5-step process to build all of my ships. And yeah, so that's it for today's episode. Next episode, we'll be moving on to the last step and finishing this darn thing up. All right. Thanks for watching, everyone.